sometimes when we are talking to our clients about the Enneagram and how we start the journey of the self-transformation, normally they tell us, I want to become better. And there is nothing to become better. We are good enough already. This is only the question on how we use the strengths of our character, of patterns, of our Enneagram type, how we apply it to our teams, to ourselves, to our personal life, and how actually we use it as the treasure we have that was given to us as our main character patterns. In Bevel, we are using the Enneagram as the methodology to assess the persona and the team. We identify the strengths and mainly we leverage the strengths of each type that are moving us along our lives, that are helping us to grow, right? So with that, we can build better relations, we can be happier at home, at work, in the relations, any kind of relations, and we have better self-esteem. We understand ourselves better and we move respectively with the confidence, with the sureness about what we are doing and what's coming next. So let's look at the Enneagram precisely. In Enneagram, you see 9 types. You can divide them in 3 groups. There are body center, the, I will show later, the emotional center, the feeling heart center, and the mental center. But the whole beauty of the Enneagram is when you explore and see the numbers and where, how you spread, is that you start using it as your strengths. You have different patterns for different types. And you see if, for instance, in the body center, the 8 is your dominant type, you see also what are the dominant type of in other centers. We teach an Enneagram how you can use all 3 centers. Body center is 8, 9, and 1. These are the 3 types that according to the Enneagram map, every person has. It's about our brain and about our instincts. And this is how we are making the decisions based on our sensations. There are 3 types. The powerful person, type 8, which are driven by the sense of power, very much driven by the sense of own power and how they influence other people and how they take care about themselves from their own leadership perspective. So another type is 9. These are the peaceful person. These are the people who are driven by the peace and harmony with themselves, inside of themselves, but also with other people. And the good person, type 1, these are the people who are driven by the goodness. These are those leaders and personality types who are creating the bars. And then in the healthy way, this is the motivational bar where the whole team needs to move. In the healthy, the bar was too high and then everyone needs to put the new challenge into the place and moving. Not in the very healthy way quite often. So in the unhealthy way, the burnouts and the stress and etc., the things like that are happening in the team environment. Let's go to the another center, which is the heart types, 2, 3, and 4. These are the emotional types. These are the types that are driven by feelings and their emotions related to others. And this is the empathetic types, right? So the type 2 is the loving person. These are people that are driven by emotions and love and attachment to others. The type 3, the effective person, this is very interesting. You would see here that those people are attracted and valued by the efficiency and competence. Those people are looking for love. Those people are looking to, for support of others, and they compete and they create new goals because they need to be recognized. Type 4 is the original person. It's very interesting profile because these people are attached to originality and authenticity. They want to be sensitive, and we need to allow them to be sensitive. We need to allow themselves to go inside of themselves and be depressed or to have their own feelings about the things. So the last type, the 3rd group, last but not least, thinkers. I'm talking here particularly about type 5, if you like, because these are the scientists. These are the wise people who are very attached to knowledge and learning. So what's happening sometimes in the business environment is that those people are learning too much And sometimes eights or threes, they're saying, can we move on? Can we create something? Can we start producing or accomplishing the goals? And these people, they need to learn, but their quality of the information and the knowledge is they are deriving. The loyal person, type six, they are very attached to loyalty, though these people are very difficult to change. This is why they are called their attached to loyalty, because they are about having the high standards and their face to the things they used to have. They are not those people who are taking the risks because there is uncertainty there. And the sevens, they are very opposite to that. These are the joyful people. They don't see the risks in life at all. Those people are simply attached to joy and they need to have the only the pleasant things in life. So when there is a crisis, when company is going to bankrupt or there is something in the pipeline doesn't work, the last person you will see on that crisis resolution meeting will be sevens. Sevens will tell you, okay, that doesn't work, so what's next? And no one is going to solve the problem. They are jumping into the new one. They are avoiding conflicts. They don't like to have the uncertainty in their relations. They want to have transparent, they want to have fun. And those are those people who are driving the creativity, the innovations, and the positive team spirit of the team. To summarize on the way how the Enneagram can be applicable for your personal life, this is the individual testing and working with the coaches to see what worries you the most and where you want to progress the most in your life. But then we extend it to the team. So we create, when all the team is making the Enneagram test, we create this team mapping. We see the spread on how it works together and what are the dominant type you have in the team and what are the resourceful and less resourceful patterns you have in the team. So we introduce it through the workshop. Everyone understands. If someone wants to work on the specific things, we do it through the one-to-one coaching. And of course, the most beautiful thing what we are doing is the team retreat. We are bringing teams somewhere. So we create the agenda that they can openly embrace the differences between them without judgment, but complementing and understanding how beautifully different they are. And the leader can understand of how he or she can create these magnificent relations between the team members, so the performance starts to grow. On the Enneagram, on the Bevel website, where you see the link, actually what we are doing, we have different types and approaches to the Enneagram and how we help individuals and businesses. So you can do the test for yourself to understand your patterns and your personality type and how you are behaving in the resourceful and resourceful way. And then we will be working with this. You will have the access to the different workshops, or you can work with one of our trainers on how to use better your strengths and your super talents and superpower. We do this for groups, for the teams, when you need to understand how you interact with people at work and how to make it better. And of course, the most beautiful, we had the Saint Valentine just several weeks ago for teams, for the couples, you know, the personal teams at home, on how we are interacting with the people we love and how different we are, and how beautifully, again, different we are, and how we can complement each other in the private life. You can connect me. You have all my contacts with the QR code, which is here to my contact card. And I wish you the beautiful rest of the day, and hope to see you soon.